Hi guys, I'm headed to Morocco soon, and there's a few odds and sods from my time in Spain that didn't quite fit anywhere else, so I thought I'd share them here. After visiting the abandoned sanatorium, Maia and I rounded off the day with a visit to Hotel Montiboli and Vila Joiosa, the jewelled village. The hotel has an amazing sea view, looking out over Benidorm Island, with a naturist beach below. Let's keep the camera facing up. Vila Joiosa has a large chocolate factory, which is very famous in Spain.
So this chocolate is actually made here, though. Okay. Chocolate and hot cars don't mix.
The cocktails were totally top-notch. I had the Mai Tai and Maia had the jungle juice. They'd even recreated the night sky above the hotel. On the way out, Maia spotted that many of the paintings were by a famous local artist called Dupereau.
This is what all the old Finistrat ladies used to look like. Because if you lost your husband, you'd wear black for the rest of your life.
For the rest of your life?
Yeah. So Finistrat was full of old ladies looking exactly like that. And I imagine that's like a little abandoned house somewhere. I really love that.
Wait a minute, is she holding a handkerchief or a fish in a bag there?
Yeah, it looks like a bag.
Not sure what that is.
He's since passed away, but he had a home in Finistrat, which I passed whilst exploring the village.
I really like this one.
The hotel has a really beautiful entrance with flowers and vines. Somewhere to return to when fortune finds me.
Oh, look at that. It's a little bit disturbing that it's pointed at the hotel.
These flowers are common throughout the Mediterranean and even in Rwanda. Maia says that locally they're called Spanish flags, especially the orange ones. We headed home through the centre of Vila Joiosa.
Okay, so when we're at Casa Chiesa in Kigali, there's a print of houses at the bottom of the garden. And we're in Vila Joiosa at the moment. And these are the exact same houses that are on the print. I will do a side-by-side comparison. But I am actually standing at a landmark. In Kigali history and Spanish history. And it's right opposite a beautiful beach with palm trees. So next time you're having tapas at Casa Chiesa, you know where the original idea came from. Oh my God, I've just found a mannequin piece in La Joiosa and it's actually missing. It's missing its boy bits.
The following day, we headed over to Maia's parents' place where she cooked a huge traditional paella.
lovely sound. Yeah, you very rarely see red squirrels in the UK anymore. He's going for the paella.
Maya's mum then introduced me to the joy of brandy over ice cream for pudding.
Hi guys, so the other day when I was in Denia, I got 3 ice cream scoops and one of them was turron and I thought that it was like fudge, but it tasted a bit more crumbly, like halva. And Maya has just got back from the supermarket and she's brought me some turron to try. So it's usually made from almonds, this one's made from peanuts, but I thought I'd open it up and give it a go.
Apparently it's very traditional at Christmas. It's very well packed. Really reminds me of halva. Yeah, it's definitely got the same texture.
Okay, muri hegwe.
It's really good. Very, very much like a very light halva. Very nutty, very sweet. Really like this. She's also brought fresh cherries, and I haven't had a fresh cherry in years.
Okay, so the delights aren't over. This one's called turron de yema tostada, and Ian has just suggested I try it. And this one is, I guess it's also turron, but it's made with eggs and almond. So it looks more like cake than the other one. It's got a very strange smell. I don't know what that smell is, but he says that it's the closest thing you can get to marzipan without actually being marzipan, so.
I see why he likes it. Very different to the other one, which is has the texture of halva, so like sand. This one, it's got more of a cakey kind of texture, so somewhere between a biscuit and cake, soggy biscuit. And it's really not an overpowering marzipan taste. It's very, very subtle. Chewy. It's really good. I like it.
Hi guys, so Maya's bought me this horchata to try. Apparently it's a very traditional Spanish milk-based drink. I think made from almonds? But apparently you can buy it in cafes and restaurants and people drink it over ice. But I'm just going to have a little sip to see what it tastes like.
Alright, let's try it. Doesn't have much of a smell. It doesn't really smell like milk, but oh, that's nice.
Very, very sweet, like sugared milk. Oh, I'll tell you what it's like. It's like the milk you have at the bottom of a cereal bowl after eating Frosties. That's what it tastes like. Okay, so Maya's just come home and she's given me this and she said, eat it, it's good. It's some sort of olive oil tortilla, so let's give it a go. Okay, it's really fragile. I've already broken it just trying to open it. Smells a little bit of olive oil, but not much of a smell. Slightly toasted olive oil. Okay. Oh, that is really good. When she said olive oil, I thought it was a savoury snack. Like the milk, it's really sweet. It's got the texture of a really, really light crumbly cracker. A little bit of a sugary sweetness and a little bit of a toasted cracker taste. So a mixture of sweet and savoury, but mostly sweet. Definitely very good.
The only downside to Spain has been the mosquitoes. I got completely ravaged one night in a nightmare game of Join the Dots, and Maya's ankle completely ballooned. Apparently, it's called skeeter syndrome when you have an extreme reaction to bites, and it occurs when you get bitten by a species of mosquito you don't usually encounter and haven't had time to build up resistance to. I found toothpaste was the best for helping to alleviate the itching, but it's taking days to go down, and I'm feeling a bit self-conscious about it, wearing a jacket in 30 degree heat. A couple of final snacks to wrap up. I tried these unicorn sour sweets. They were yummy, but I couldn't tell you what flavour they were. These cookies were nice. White chocolate caramelly goodness. And can we all take a moment to appreciate how cheap the wine is here? These were the expensive ones.